Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and I've got some pre-release WWE 2K16 info and action for you today. Now, I was flown out to 2K Studios in San Fran about a week and a half ago. Got a chance to sit down and have extensive hands-on time with the game and to record whatever I could in that day sitting with a near-final build of the game. Not completely final, but near-final build. And one of the things I wanted to look at here briefly, this was kind of as things were winding down during the day and I was just trying to record as much as possible across the board. One of the things that's back this year is create a custom diva. And so I wanted to look in the creation suite at creating a diva before I left the studios. I think this might actually have been the very last thing I recorded that day. So it's a bit brief, but you'll have to bear with me here. I just wanted to get anything I could on this information out here. So you have the face templates, which I think are much better this year. They're more to choose from. I like that you can see the overview of how somebody looks instead of a list just saying face 1 through 20 and then having a loading screen load and load and load and finally showed you some kind of freaky looking face. Here at least you can kind of see the thumbnail of, okay, I can see what that face looks like. Let's go check that one out. Let's go check number 16 or number 12. And all these templates look good. Of course, you can do mass customization of the faces if you want to on your own, all the eye placement. And we saw some pretty silly ones, people creating superstars and divas in the studio. It was kind of comical on some of them. But anyway, sticking with face templates here, checked this one out. This one looked intriguing. I kind of like the hairstyle. Let's pull this one up and take a look at it. How does this one look? This is number... Actually, those aren't numbers. I guess those are just total points used on the face. Oh, the hair is pretty interesting on that one. I could definitely go with that model if I wanted to. I'm not sure if this is the final one I went with. I think I still messed around with a couple more just for the sake of checking out some variety here. Let's go down here. I'm not going to go with the blue-faced one down there, although that does intrigue me a little bit. All right, let's check this one out here. What do we got when this one loads up? All these templates looking pretty good. And there we go. Okay. Oh, we got some major eye makeup, eyeshadow going on there. And let's take a look at playing with the hair. Because one of the things I heard and confirmed in here is that you can do like hair dye. You can do streaks of hair dye in here now. You can kind of get that Seth Rollins effect. You can kind of get that Natalya. Oh, speaking of Natalya, that's kind of the Natalya effect right there. The streaks of pink there of the hair dye. And right here it says you can put in a mesh of your preferred color and then change the size of it. So this is kind of nice. You basically take like a spray paint can and go to the area you want to affect on the hair here, right there. You can kind of just spray it right in as if you had a spray paint can, and you can control your hair dye that way, and you can change that to any color you want, to any part of the hair graphic, which is really nice. You can have much more control over your effect of what you're trying to do here. Now, am I doing a great job of this? No, but I'm just trying to do a quick paint job to show you how the tool works. So when you get your hands on it yourself, you'll kind of know what to expect. So there, we did a little bit of the hair dyeing back here. I think I stopped messing around with this pretty soon. But it's cool right there. Okay, so if that was my final diva character, I probably wouldn't have just spray painted the back of her head like that with hair dye, but probably would have spent a little more time. But just for creation's sake, wanted to check that out and make that an addition there. All right, so you see how that works? That's got a lot of potential there to definitely distinguish your diva characters when you're creating them and give them a unique look with the hair and everything. So I like how the hair is flowing too. That's pretty cool. Like in the past, obviously on previous gen, you'd see a lot of hair just kind of sticking straight out and staying still. You see a lot of bounce and wave to the hair, which is nice. And here is the face photo import thing. And now, okay, I don't exactly get this lined up. And they also told us that these pictures that were in here for us to use, they were like the default ones. I don't know if they're 2K staff or who lended their pictures, but they were quite low resolution. So they said when we take higher resolution pictures, they'll probably turn out better. But you can line these things up. You can have a photo of your own face or your friend's face, or celebrity's face that you want to put in, and you import it in the game, and you can do the tweaks here and get them in the face import this year, which is pretty cool. So that's right in there for both Superstars and Divas creations, which is very nice. But we'll stick with the template here just because it looked a little sharper than what I was messing with. Obviously, you have the ability to go in and change all the facial features and where cheekbones are and the bridge of your nose and how the lips look and all that stuff. You can do all that still. And I just wanted to get in here before I'm done into what we're looking at for clothing and layers. So we probably won't get a look at everything we've got in here, but you can definitely take a look at what we've got for like masks. Now, I don't know if it shows up in the Diva creation, but when we were in the Superstar creation, they actually have Adam Rose's bunny. They've got the bunny mask. Your actual wrestler can wear the bunny mask this year, so that's pretty sweet. Get her a pair of shades right here. Obviously, you can change colors. And the nice thing this year is you got the material. You can change the material on everything, on the clothing and on the items. So that's kind of a nice change they've made. That'll, again, add a lot more customization because you could have the same outfit done in six different materials and they give a different look to them. So you see some hats here, some choices. You got some horns. If you want to give them Viking horns or devil horns or ram horns on there. It looks like you can make them up as the Statue of Liberty. Ooh, is that like a motorcycle helmet? That's pretty cool. You see bunny ears down there, but there's the full-blown bunny head, I think, if I would have gone over to the WWE other section. But, hey, let's check this out. All right, that's looking pretty good. So I'm thinking what she needs with this eventually. I wonder if they've got like a grass skirt to put in there. We'll have to look. But you can see tops here. Obviously, going through all the different sections, you can give them like bikini tops. Basically any. Obviously, they've got shirts and they've got the templates for full clothing templates and all that stuff still in. But the graphics are looking sharp here. You can obviously go change colors on anything you want, as I'm showing you right there. Kind of going the purple theme right here. But you know what she needs. If they have it in here, she's getting a grass skirt to go with that headdress she's got on. Let's go check out. Oh, I see it. It's down there. You see some very short shorts are in play there too, a la AJ Lee. But there you go. Grass skirt. We've got our hula girl diva, I guess, is what we'll identify her as here just for the sake of creating one to show you what we can work with here. But so that's just kind of a brief look at what you're looking at in the new creation suite as far as divas go. It's nice to have it back in the game that we can create our own divas. It's definitely going to help in your universe modes and all that stuff when we're playing here to get some variety, especially getting more divas into the game. So I hope you like this quick brief look. Man, we're so close to release now. WWE 2K16, cannot wait. What's your first diva creation going to be? Let me know in the comments. I'll see you later. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!